This is Sam Cap and Sam Dub with Sam We Are. Yay. It's just us today.
It is. It's just family today. Yeah. Yeah, I kind of like it. I kind of like the going back and forth, you know, because everyone totally wants to hear our opinions and our thoughts and everything. So, you know, we got to give those people what they want.
That's true. I know. It's so hard. Sometimes when we're interviewing people, I'm so talkative that I'm just like, that's interesting. That's interesting. But let me tell you what I think about it. You know, I just like want to bust in and tell them.
Hey, that's like my opinion. Our description. We're opinionated. I mean, you're here because you love it, obviously.
Yeah, exactly. I don't think anyone would listen to someone's podcast if they didn't want to hear their opinion, right?
Yeah, exactly.
That's kind
of the
ticket.
All my Facebook rants like come to life, you know, when people leave the like Michael Jackson eating popcorn gif, you know, because they're just like enjoying this confrontation go down. Yeah, that's usually how
I like that.
But this is a positive spin on that, of course.
That's true. And we both are very vocal on social media. So I think that this
is how we became friends.
That's how we became friends. I think this is sort of like, you're right. It's like this coming to life, our social media personas.
Yeah.
Although that's a whole, I'm not even going to get into that. That's not even what I want to, I was going to say people's internet personas are so different from their real personas sometimes.
Most of the time.
Yeah. And I know we all have a different, you know, we all have to sort of create this persona, but I try to keep it as real as I can, as often as
I
can. You do too. Yeah. And I appreciate that about you because I, it's so interesting when you meet people who are very vocal on social media, very loud, very opinionated. Then you meet them in real life and they're just like little mice and they don't say a word. And I think that that's the strangest thing to me. And it's like they sort of hide behind the keyboard, you know?
No, I totally,
And it can come out in bad ways, right? Because certain
people
can hide behind the keyboard and then be a little bit like meaner behind their keyboards because there's that sense of anonymity.
Yeah.
This isn't what I wanted to talk about. But
I think just to end like a thought there, I think that that's, you know, something that we bonded on too is because like we were like super open and super honest about like how we felt about things. And I know for you and I both, you know, we've got a lot of positivity in the way of, I'm thinking of Colby right
I
now
was
when
just
her
about
saying
to say,
fuck positivity.
Not
okay.
I'm not toxic. I know she scared me away from I almost said from Colby. She scared me away from positivity forever.
Yeah.
I keep thinking,
I'm going to say encouragement.
That's a good way to say it. Yeah, I like that.
We both receive encouragement from other people that are like super thankful for, you know, people out there being honest about whatever it may be. And I feel like that kind of drives me to keep doing it because I've gotten so many like really sweet Facebook messages, really sweet LinkedIn messages just from people appreciating me like speaking out about something. So that's kind of fueled my fire. But yeah, that is not what we were going to talk about.
But that's a good point. I like the way that you said that, though. I know. Now we're just going to go on.
Now we're
going to
ramble.
I like the way that you said that, though, because it's true. Like I do get, I don't know, it's that, oh, we're so famous on social media. But no, I mean, some of us are, but I do get those messages from people, whether they're saying, oh, I love this recipe that you just posted and it inspired me to make this other thing. And I sent, you know, and they send me a picture of it. And like, that makes me feel so good because as we both know, there's so many different ways to promote veganism, to promote any lifestyle. Whatever that lifestyle may be. And so I think that it's easy to kind of get caught up in the negative and like and not promote that positive aspect of it. Like, you know, I can make people, you know, people will want to eat vegan food just by seeing something I created, not because I go up to them and go, did you know that every day that billion cows get murdered and it's because of you and your fucking hamburgers? Like,
I feel attacked.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, but you're never going to get anyone on your side that way. So, you know, there's like so many ways to not be positive, but encourage others to be their whole selves or be their true selves by just being, you know, bringing your authentic self to the table. And I think that that is something that we really bond over. And it's something that I think people hate on social media so often. And I don't know. I love social media. I have to say, I love
social
media.
It's amazing.
It's nice. It's brought me a lot of good things in my life.
Yeah.
I would never have met you. I would never have met my partner. I wouldn't be able to connect with so many people that I connect with. I wouldn't learn about vegan things that I didn't know about from other people, you know?
For sure.
And so, yeah, it brings such a good sense of like community, but people can really use it for like a negative.
Of course. People fuck everything up.
People
I know. You give the people good things and what do? They go fuck it up. That's just what they do, especially Americans.
Yeah.
You know, we're just, God, let's just.
People just love trolling. It's so interesting. You know, I'm like, I never have been that kind of person who was like, let me troll. Let me comment this like negative, hateful thing. Like sometimes I'll think, oh, I want to comment this like shady thing. And I type it out and then I just delete it and keep it to myself. And I'm like, all right, that was a funny joke. You know I was funny. I don't need to piss someone off, you know, just to make fun of them. And anyway, that's all that I have to say on people being mean on social media. Be nice, everyone. No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah, be nice.
Be nice. Don't be mean. But, you know, honestly, if you don't have anything nice to say, shut the fuck up and keep it to yourself.
I like
you
know? That. Let's put that on a T-shirt. But yeah, we were flowing earlier about, you know, what were we talking about? We were saying, oh, I was telling you that I got my Halloween costume. Halloween.
What are you going to be for Halloween?
I am going to be Samara from The Ring.
Okay. You love scary stuff.
I do. So last year I was the nun. I don't know if anyone's ever seen that movie, but it's really fucking awesome. And I loved it. It's a scary movie, though. Don't get me wrong. So like, if you piss your pants, it's not my fault. It is scary.
I almost do that like every day and particularly when I sneeze. So you know what I'm saying? It's just like I don't need anything to make me piss my pants more than I almost already do on the daily, you know?
But yeah, so I'm going to be Samara.
Yeah,
hopefully.
That was Sam.
Yeah.
Oh, that's so scary. I don't like that.
Yes.
But as a Jew, whatever. Fuck that. Fuck that nun. I'm not scared of you, evil nun.
You know. I had the blood like coming out of my mouth and everything. Like my husband painted my face. I looked so legit. It was amazing. And I threw a Halloween party last year. So my like whole thrill of the night was I would wait till people would pull up and like walk up into the house and I would creep around the side and I would fucking come out at them. And some people, I scared them so bad that they were pissed off. They were pissed. Like, I scared the shit out of this woman that I didn't even know. And, like, I, like, came up and I was laughing. I was like, oh, hey, it's me, Sam. And they were like, I was like, oh, I don't know you. I'm so sorry. Like, but why are you here? Like, who are you? And But it was my father-in-law's coworker. But I scared her so bad.
No. I'm glad I didn't go to that party. And I do not play games with scary stuff. Don't look at me, bitch. I will hurt
this up. This has been brought up. So people would have, oh, sorry. There's just that no one's seeing that. That's up on that. So this has been brought up and I wanted to bring this back around because you had mentioned the G word. And then you said you teased it for the next episode. And we're like, now people have maybe seen that episode already, but they were like, wait, yeah, what are we having? So I didn't know if you wanted to talk
about
the
memory,
G-words.
The G word.
Ghost.
Wow.
Careful.
I mean,
careful.
You just triggered me. But
Jesus.
I'm just kidding. I'm sorry. Please don't cancel me.
That was a good one. Sounded like a legit audio tape right there.
I was like,
Are you going to dress up for Halloween?
Yeah, not as a fucking ghost, though.
What are you going to be?
See, I don't curse except when I'm hype. You guys made me hype. I just told y'all I don't curse. Now I'm tense. I feel like my asshole's clenching. My nipples are hard. I'm scared. You know what I'm saying? I'm scared. They're not hard because it's hot in here. But yeah, they're like mentally they're hard. But yeah, I'm terrified. What am I going to be? So I think Aaron and I want to do a couple's costume.
Oh, yes. I remember we talked about this.
And Aaron is black, I am white, and we have a lot of options. And so one of the things that we want to do is if anyone's seen the show Disjointed, which this we could pull up, actually. I'm sorry, I should have said this sooner, but I didn't know we were going to talk about my costume. But Dank and Dabby from Disjointed, those are the characters that we're going to be, Dank and Dabby. They're just like these hilarious... Yes. I mean, is that not me?
It is a pretty funny show.
I'm also wearing that haircut, the hairstyle right now.
You really are.
Literally wearing the hairstyle.
It's perfect.
And I think her name is Betsy Soldano, and that's Chris Redd. Chris Redd's on SNL.
Yeah, they're pretty funny.
So funny. Betsy Soldano is hilarious. And they're both
Sidero.
Really...
Betsy Sidero is
Sidero,
very
did
funny.
I say her name wrong?
Yeah, it's okay.
What did I say? Soldano?
Soldano. So it's pronounced Sidero. Oh, she's from, she does some great improv work. She's really funny.
Thank you. I apologize. Sorry. No,
I apologize. It's fine.
And she's not listening, so it's okay.
Women apologize too much. Stop it.
Yeah, no, that's cool. She's an awesome person. She's so funny on this show, and then I realized that she does all this other stuff with comedy. So I started following her on social media. But yeah, I'm literally wearing that hairstyle right now. I just need to get like a laser cat, you know, space laser cat shirt.
I think Wes has that shirt.
I think Aaron has one too. I was like, okay, I don't even think I need to buy one. And like a purple sweater. And like literally that's it. And he just needs to wear like a stoner shirt and a hat. And we just need to be high. So that's pretty easy. That's a pretty smooth, I think. Yeah. Costume for us, and also just like a funny couple's costume. And I've never done a couple's costume.
I feel like I up until last year, I have done a few I've done a few couples costumes. Like 2 years ago, Wes and I were Belle and the Beast from Beauty and the Beast.
That's cute. I feel like I saw those pictures. Those
we did the Game of Thrones things. He was Jason Momoa. Did I ever show you the pictures of him as Jason Momoa? Because you will enjoy it.
But I will look at
yeah. And
Jason Momoa will be brought up on every episode.
Pretty much.
Just let you know, it's going to go at the bottom of
my God. What if like eventually he like hears of this and then he like wants to call in?
What if we became so famous that Jason Momoa was on our show?
Oh my God.
Wouldn't that be the tits? Please like and subscribe. No, I'm just kidding. So that Jason Momoa can find us. I mean, look, I feel like between the two of us, we have some powers of social media.
Wes was Jason Momoa for Halloween last year, too. He's done it twice.
It's going to happen. Well, whether or not the real Jason Momoa is going to do it, or we'll get Wes as Jason Momoa.
Yes.
Jason Momoa is coming on the show. I'm just saying.
It's written in the stars.
It's written in the stars. I'm manifesting it right now.
Manifesting.
Is that like from Cats?
What I have
that?
No fucking idea.
Sounded like a ballad from Cats. I was like, oh shit, Cats.
I've been quoting Hocus Pocus a lot, so I know it's not from that. But
I like that. Speaking of Cats, and just side note, everyone hated the movie Cats. Like they were like, oh, it was the worst movie ever. Now, first of all, sure, we all knew it was going to be a bad movie. If you thought it was going to be good, I don't know what you were, you know, snorting in the 80s, but like we knew it was going to be a bad movie. Yeah. But then like the fact that we knew it was going to be bad. And then when it came out, everyone said it was going to be bad. So like when I went to go see it, I was like, oh, I know this is going to be horrible, you know? And like, I loved every minute of it. It was like one of those things where I think the only reason if you hated it was if you've never tripped acid. If you've ever tripped acid, that movie made a lot of sense. Do you know what I'm saying?
No.
It made complete sense to me.
No idea.
I was like, I get it from start to finish. Even like the fucked up CGI, I was like, I get it all.
I didn't see it.
I took it all in. Do you know what I mean? It was so fucked up, but it's one of those things where I'd love to do it on acid.
Okay. That's okay.
Just side note to anyone.
What my mind thought of when you said it was like, you know, people thought this movie was going to be bad. My mind went to... what's that? I feel like, Neil, you're going to know the answer to this and take this as you will. It's not me judging you, but it's the movie with like the little mannequins and they like fucking stuff.
They fucking
and it's like America. Oh, fuck yeah.
Team America.
Yes. That is what made me think of it because everyone was like, oh, my God, this movie's going to suck. Like, what is this movie? And I enjoyed every minute of it, and right. It was fucking puppets.
Yeah. I love that you thought that he would know it, and I'm sure he does. But yeah. I was like, oh,
I don't know. You just seem like a guy that would know
like
that
last year. You know what I'm saying? Like,
I have a douchey.
That's a great
face.
Movie.
That's understandable. It's yeah, a very douchey look about me. I
you
get
do
it.
No your fault. Like, no, you it's do not. Have a douchey look.
I do.
And I like, how can we fix it? Like, can you just wear like a shirt that says like, I'm nice, I'm not
right.
an asshole.
No,
like, what can
tough.
We do?
I think I could be more quirky. I used to be. I mean, I used to be goth when I was younger. So I mean,
same.
Yeah.
That makes sense.
We don't need to. Oh, now's the day. If you hear anything in the background, it's only because we're building a jacuzzi. I don't know what it is. They're doing work upstairs, so I apologize for anybody. I'll take it out and post. It's fine.
I want a fucking jacuzzi.
I know.
I was like,
right?
Do you have a jacuzzi here?
I know. Wouldn't it be great if I
Are you teasing?
We don't even have a tub.
All right.
Anyway, it's all stand-up shower.
That was a tease, and that made me upset, but it's fine.
I'm going to lessen my douchey. Anyway, keep going.
Oh, yeah. We're done roasting Neil.
Yeah, no,
but
it's
Cats was bad. There we go. I think that's how we left there.
Yeah, Cats was bad. Oh, no. Cats was good.
But you
like what I was saying.
Well, here's
yeah.
the thing, though. Here's what my question for you is, if we can then move, because you haven't seen it. I haven't seen it all the way through.
Yeah.
Okay.
What do you think if you just saw that version of it and that was the only version you knew of it? Would you like it more than the old version that you might have seen on stage?
I've never seen a version on stage.
Okay. Well, then
I've
we need to stop this conversation.
I've never seen a version on stage, but I'm a theater kid, so yeah. I'm familiar with it. I know some of the songs from it. I understand the concepts of it. I also know that everyone hates it, and I know the reasons why. I get it, you know? Yeah. I feel like it's one of those movies I don't...
That's not exactly what I was looking for. But here we go.
That was hilarious. Yeah.
Hey guys, I'm always good for one little quick one liner.
It was as if you Googled like pussy.
Yeah. So you have the anthropomorphic cats. I'll bring this up so people can see this. So this is the big problem with the whole thing. It was they did anthropomorphic cats. Now you have the old style here. You know, which is like the theater dress up, the grittier version that still was weird.
Yeah.
And I don't want to take over any of this.
It's all weird.
But yeah, so if you don't know like what we're talking about.
I don't know anything.
There is this, you know stuff. Come on. But there is this. This is like a very, you know, but it kind of got through on being weird, but also kind of fun. And it's been on Broadway this whole time, right?
Yeah.
And then they went over and did like weird anthropomorphic cats. In this digital weird version. And it also, they gave them like genitals or not. I can't remember if they had given them like true to form genitals.
Not
and
really, but they I were think, sexual. They were very sexual cats, yes. Which they were in the original too. Like the whole thing is this very weird, sexual, nonsensical, you know,
cats
situation. But yeah, I mean, I went into it just knowing it was going to be horrible. I got high as fuck. I was in the movie theater with a vape, just
going.
And also, I haven't been to the movies in forever.
Sure.
And so, like, I didn't know. And of course, this was all pre-COVID. But I didn't know that, like, when you go to the movie theater these days, it's, like, mad chill. You get, like, your assigned seat. There's, like, liquor. You have, like a seat warmer. Your feet go
Where
up.
The fuck did you go?
I felt like I was living in the future. Do you know what I mean?
I go to like South Philly Riverview. Don't go, okay. It is not like that. That is like.
That's the one I used to go to.
That's the old place.
And then I guess I went to the new one in the. Well, you know, I'm from Philly. We called it the gallery back in the day, but whatever it's called.
I didn't even know there was a movie theater there.
There's a movie theater and it has all those fancy things I just described.
Well, that's dope. Is it open or did it fucking close?
I'm sure it didn't like shut down permanently. I don't know if they're back open again. Yeah. I think I saw movie theaters are open. Again,
yeah, they are open. But, yeah.
So, I mean, I'm sure that they are open.
I don't know if Riverview made it, actually.
Oof, I don't know.
They were like, I think they were struggling before. And if you're not familiar with what I'm talking about in Riverview, it's this older movie theater that's like at least a good 10 years behind all the rest of the movie theaters. It's big though. It's pretty big for South Philly. And it's always just been chill if you can get past all the children. But other than that, it's just cheap and it's close. That's where we go. And they have parking. Yeah. That's a big one.
Check out this new one. I mean, it doesn't have parking because it's downtown.
I would just walk.
But I mean, worth it for sure to get that comfort. It was one of those things where I was like, okay, like this is why I would keep going back to the movies because I feel like I quit for so long because I was just like, what am I paying for?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I feel like there's no movies that are going to be coming out. There's going to be like a little bit of a gap where there's just like nothing because no one's filming. I don't even think still filming, are they?
They all stopped and I thought they started again. But
everyone just has to wear a mask type thing.
There's been like different stuff.
Totally. Yeah.
No, there's
been
a lot.
Cool.
But anyway, that was cats. None of the things that we intended to talk about.
Yeah, none of the things Halloween, we intended to speak
about. And then we got
about.
Over to cats. You guys got over to cats.
What are you? So, so I'm going to be Dank and Dabby. You're going to be
Samara from The Ring.
We're going to not talk about ghosts.
I bought my costume.
We're not going to talk about the G
word. Even though you said you teased it and you were going to talk about it.
Talk about how much I hate it.
I wanted to know why you're so scared of ghosts. We're Halloween people, clearly.
Are you not scared of ghosts?
I grew up with a cemetery in my backyard.
I've never seen a ghost one. I've looked for them in the insane asylums that have been run down.
Oh my God, we need to talk about that.
Not now, bitches. Can. You can talk about it off or when I'm gone next week.
I think
when I go on vacation, you guys can talk about it.
She's got a deathly problem with, you're like super scared of Halloween.
I'm going to go. Yeah.
She doesn't like talking about it. I'm sorry if I'm making you uncomfortable.
Would you do it? Would you go to Penhurst with ghost hunting equipment for $100,000? You would do it, bitch.
For $100,000 for one night?
You had to stay the whole time, though. You had to stay from 9 o'clock p.m. to 5 o'clock a.m. And if you left the premises, it automatically, like, you lost.
This is the beginning of a horror movie. Yeah, I would. I know what I would do. I would take it. I would just take a sleeping pill, fall asleep. Whatever happened to my
that's
body?
Not allowed.
Well, listen, you don't know what I'm on. If I just pass out, are you going to drug test me? You know?
Yes.
That's my plan for getting through anything scary. I'm like, I'll just take drugs and I'll be fine. So, yeah, no, I don't fuck with that shit. I have really intense dreams. I'm a lucid dreamer. And I have really intense dreams. And so I don't like thinking about scary stuff like that, because then I will dream about it in the middle of the night and I wake up feeling stressed, you know? Like this morning I woke up and I looked at my boyfriend and I said, I just had the craziest dream. Do you want to hear about it? And he's like, yeah, because he knows I have these insane, wild dreams. He was like, he always wants to hear. I think most of the time people are like, I don't want to hear about your dreams. I don't know why I want to hear about your dreams. Like, Tell me your dreams. I mean, all your dreams, like, you know, real and otherwise. But yeah, I mean, I think that they're really fascinating. I think that they come from a part of your brain that is like deep seated that you're not even thinking about. So if you want to know, I'll tell you briefly, really fast. 30 seconds. Okay. I'm just letting you tune out. You can fast forward if you don't want to hear about my dream, but, although you guys have to hear it. I'm so sorry. You too. But so last night I'm in my dreamscape and I'm in this Dunkin' Donuts and this blonde bitch who happened to be some blonde girl that I was in camp with, who I guess I never got along with, whose name was Heather, who I haven't seen or spoken to in 20 years. She cuts me in line. And my Philly ass in my dream goes, uh-uh. And I take her by her blonde hair. I pull her head back and then I smash it on the ground. Then there's a crowd of people behind us and I run out of the Dunkin' Donuts. Then I'm on the lam. You know, now I'm running from police. I get back to my apartment. My dad's there. There's all these people. Like, my house was blended with my parents' house, which was an interesting combo. So basically I walked up like the front of my where I live now. And then I got up to my apartment, but it was the inside of my parents' house. So that was freaky. And my dreams are like so detailed. I remember all of these, you know what I mean? I remember all of this. And I also lucid dreaming means, if anyone doesn't realize this, that like I can wake up, go back into my dream, and I can also like kind of control a lot of aspects of my dreams. And so one of the things that I can control most with my dreams is just the ability to actually go back into a dream. So like I can wake up, pee, come back and go back into the exact same.
I've done that.
Sorry.
Yeah. No, I do get out of bed.
It's usually a nightmare.
Yeah, exactly. And so, yeah. So, and then also just being able to sort of like be knowledgeable that like I'm dreaming and like, okay, try to figure out what I can do in there. And so anyway, yeah. So that was interesting. I was on the lam and these cops were searching us. People were rolling blunts in my dad's studio. And I was like, this is my dad's office. You guys can't smoke blunts in here. You could go right outside though. I was like so mad at them. There were like a bunch of comedians there. It was super weird. But yeah, I don't know why I bashed this woman's head and like I ran from the scene of the crime. Like, damn, like I just sprinted. But yeah, that was one of my weird dreams. So
what do you think it means?
That's a good question. I've been watching Z Nation recently, which is a zombie show. So I don't like ghost shit, but I do fuck with zombies and stuff, you know?
Interesting. Okay.
Well, I just want to be prepared. And I guess that's how people who like ghosts feel, right?
Yeah.
Do you like want to be prepared if you find, like if you see or find one?
I just feel like there's nothing scarier than real life.
True.
So what the fuck's a ghost? Like, I feel like if I saw a ghost, I'd be like, wow, there really is some more shit to this. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, you don't just like my theory is like when you die, you just kind of like get sucked out of your body and you like go straight into a black hole. Gotcha. Like that makes sense to me. I don't know about you guys, but I feel like it's possible.
Do you feel like ghosts aren't real or you do feel like ghosts are real?
I don't know.
I feel that.
I feel like, honestly, if you believe in fucking dinosaurs, which I mean, dinosaurs obviously there's bones to prove that. I'm saying, but like the whole concept of dinosaurs actually being real to me is like mind blowing. You know, like fucking T-Rex was real. Right. Holy fucking shit. Right. Like, right.
I get, and then people believe
aliens. And people believe like there's multiple universes out there. Like, I feel like the concept of a ghost to me is just not that hard to believe when you think like of all the other crazy shit out there.
I agree with that. And the way that you put it, I sort of like the way that I can fuck with ghosts is a couple ways. So I can like fuck with ghosts if they're, you could see I'm cursing. I'm very stressed.
Yeah.
I just want everyone
we
to
both
know.
Started cursing frequently.
I'm very stressed right now.
We don't even know what's at the bottom of the ocean, first of all. Maybe there's ghosts down there. I don't know. Maybe that's where they live.
I guess like how I can wrap my mind around ghosts is like if there's like sci-fi, you know, I watch a lot of sci-fi. So in sci-fi, you'll sometimes get these sort of like sci-fi ghost situations, but they're not just like random. You know, what I don't like is Neil's like, I'm getting to the meat of it. Neil's my therapist right now. This is great. Thank God I quit therapy to pay for this podcast. That's so awesome. No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. I'm kidding, everyone. Please like and subscribe. Just kidding. But yeah, I think what I don't like about it is like if I can't understand it, right? So like, okay, what is a ghost? You know, if I don't understand the science behind it or the magic behind it or whatever it is that's creating this ghost, then I'm not into it, you know? So like,
okay,
I guess if I'm watching something like a sci-fi and it's not just this like random scary ghost killing everyone, jumping out. And I also don't like in scary movies when they sort of have that jumpy moment, you know, I'm not into that. Like,
that's my favorite.
I'm not trying to have a heart attack, you know, like I'm a Jew. My I'm scared enough already at any given moment, you know.
I scare the shit out of Wes at least once a week. Every week. Since I've met him.
Do you just jump out at him?
Yes, I plan it out. So like, it's just as simple as like, you know, us getting home from like a restaurant or whatever, and I'll like quickly just run upstairs and like I'll just, you know, dip somewhere and like I'll see him walk up and I get up and I just like scream. And he every time, I'm gonna start filming it. That's my thing. I need to remember to like get it on tape because it's fucking hilarious.
No, I don't like that.
He doesn't either.
No, don't scare me. I'll like pee my pants. Or I'll shit, you know, like, I don't know. I got IBS. Like, don't scare me. I could poop at any given
you
moment.
Could,
you know,
scare the literal shit out of Sam. So don't do it.
Scare me. Yeah. That's tough. I'm just kidding, Neil. Don't worry.
I don't know. I
love this all things scary.
This is the most serious I've seen you, I think.
Yeah, in terms scared.
I'm very scared. Which to me, I want to move on because I don't want anyone. I didn't know how serious it was. So I don't want to go on to it.
Well, I mean, that actually means a lot to me though, because, you know, our first friendship adventure was at the Eastern Penitentiary, like we mentioned before. So it was actually nice that you came with me, because for me that was like fun. I'm like, woo, yeah, scary shit. And like, you were probably scared, even though you've done it a bunch of times. You're probably still scared.
Yeah, that one like doesn't count for me because I've done it like every year for the past 20 years.
Yeah.
So I know every room. Like, I am like, I can literally count. I'm like, okay, this is the first out of sixth, you know, event. I'm like, okay, we're in medical. Next we go to the ward. I don't know, like whatever. Like, I just like know every
control.
Single.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. That makes I'm like, sense. Oh, we're in the psychedelic one. Like, I don't know. I know them really well. I also like know a lot of the people who work there and put them on and stuff. So I feel like I'm like, oh, I know that person. And it's like a little less scary.
Yeah. Still, I'm glad you know, came.
I would never do the one where they can touch you and move
you. I wanted to do that so bad, but then I knew I wouldn't be with you, which kind of defeated the purpose of going with you. So I was like, I'll stay with you pussies.
Yeah. They like separate you out and like make you crawl through shit. Yeah. I'm like,
I was into it.
I also think, not to bring it all back to Nazis, but I just think to circle back. I think I think that sort of like scariness of like, oh, let me grab you and move. Like, I'm like, oh, like this is like hits too close to home, you know, like I don't fuck with that. But yeah, I just like to be able to know how everything works if I don't understand how it
so
works.
So black is like your. Yeah, and black being, if anyone doesn't know, black is blackout. Yeah. But blackout being your worst, like most terrifying thing that you could ever, which is supposed to be.
See, black. I think that's like the most thrilling. So that's like interesting. Sure. Like for me, when I go to like haunted things like that, like no matter what it is, there's a really good one in South Philly too, by the way. I forget what it's called, but I've done like all of them and I always go with like a couple of friends. And for me, I'm like, I have to go first. Like I want to go first because I want to be the first one that's like scared, because if someone else goes first, they're going to be like such a pussy about it and scream, you know, whereas I'm going to like smile and laugh. Does that say a lot about me? I don't know. It makes me sound sadistic a little.
No.
I don't think so.
No, and okay, I get the way that you put it, where you're like, real life is scarier.
It is.
And especially as what we're dealing with lately, like, yeah, I mean, real life is scarier than whatever.
Like, what's the scariest thing that could possibly happen? You see a floating like spirit that's like, help me, like I was hit by a car and I'm just like floating here.
No,
I don't really know what I'm supposed
to
do.
It's not the ones that need help. It's the ones that try to kill you.
I think those are called demons. Those aren't ghosts.
I stan Casper, you know what I'm saying?
I would fucking love to have a Casper. But like, oh my God.
I don't mess with those, like, you know, scary where they're trying to murder you and so they're stuck in the house and they're like, this is my house.
No, those are like demons.
My house, bitch.
Those are demons, poltergeists. Mm. Like, those are like bad energy spirits, but there's a lot of good energy spirits that I believe could be trapped here. That makes sense.
I agree with that. And like, I do watch a lot of sci-fi, and I feel like there's like a lot of ghosts in like Buffy. There's a lot of ghosts, you know, like, and I sort of like, I get that. I'm like, all right, I can understand this, you know.
Where's the line? Where's your line for watching movies? I like that. I like where you're at with sci-fi and lines and stuff like that. Because I don't want you to be scared, but like, where's your scary sci-fi line for movies and stuff?
I just don't like, I don't like pop scares. Horror.
You
don't I
don't want like pop scares. Horror.
Yeah, I don't like. It's like horror, and gore doesn't bother me.
I don't like gore.
But, yeah.
Oh, this is crazy. You're all over the place.
Yeah. I know.
Yeah, like I watch the zombie show, and it's just like right. gore, well, gore,
it,
gore.
It depends on the gore. So like, there's a couple of like scary movies, and like I love scary movies. Obviously, there's a couple of scary movies that fucked me real hard, and I didn't enjoy it. So like, have you ever seen the movie? I don't even know if this is classified as a scary movie.
My heart's tell like, me I'm, wrong. I'm about to have a heart attack.
I think we need to stop because I keep looking over.
You guys, not a ghost. Not a ghost.
She's looking over at Cap, and she's kind of. I'm like, there's moments where I see her eyes dragging, and she's kind of just like,
it's not like, a ghost. It's
like she's going back and
I'm
forth.
So sweaty. Like,
yeah, well, because
it's not
you're like
good in here either. I apologize. Attacking.
Yeah, you're like, oh my god, if it scares Sam, can, then what the I've, fuck? No, okay. But the movies were Hostel.
Sure.
Okay.
That movie is a fucked up movie.
Yeah. Sure.
Don't like stuff like that. And then the other movie was yeah. I'm not a huge fan of the Saw movies.
Okay. See, I've seen all of that and it doesn't bother
I don't
me.
I just yeah. didn't like them. Like torture it's just porn. Not my cup of tea. Yeah.
It's like torture porn. Or
yeah, I don't like
yeah.
that.
Yeah. I, you know, yeah. it's not my favorite. I don't yeah. think I want to sit there and watch it.
Yeah.
It's just sort of like I'll just like look away at that sort of stuff.
Yeah.
I've gotten better over the years. Like I've gotten better. Moving along.
I knew it. I was like, yeah, let's get off this.
You guys have like a bat mask now. I know. Get rid of the bat mask.
We love Halloween. We love Halloween so much that I actually had my wedding on Halloween weekend.
Yeah.
And I made it a classy Halloween theme. Like I went the like fall route. I was going to make it a dress up party and I was going to have everyone like that came in a costume. But then I was so worried that like, not enough people would put enough effort into it and it would end up upsetting me. I'm like, really? This is my wedding and this is what the fuck you came up with? Like you had 6 months, bitch. Right. Like I would have got offended. Yeah. And then another thought I had was we were going to have our bridal party, like dress up, just the bridal party, dress up as like monsters. And we were going to do the Thriller dance. Mm-hmm. And then I was like, we had multiple groomsmen that were so drunk before the ceremony even started. Yep. So I was like, the chances of getting these motherfuckers to do a synchronized dance is slim to none. So I just like let that idea go.
Yeah.
But that's how much I love Halloween. It was a Halloween wedding.
And to segue into weddings, to get off of the Halloween, well, we'll talk about my other least favorite subject. I'm just
Halloween
kidding.
And weddings.
I'm just
and I had a Halloween
podcast
wedding
for you ever.
Everything I hate. No, I'm just kidding. I was, well,
opposites attract.
Yeah, that's true. Well, we were just talking about this. Like, I think people think that I hate like marriage and weddings and all of that sort of stuff. But I don't hate any of that. I actually just hate the sort of like basic tradition of it, you know, and this sort of like, oh, I'm going to do the exact same thing and my ring will be the exact same and my dress will be the exact same. And I'll have it at this country club and we'll have this rubber ass chicken and like, it'll be terrible. And then I'll hate my husband. And it's just like, you know, I'm just
that went down.
That was a very
so
interesting
fast.
Leap. That was a very the logical leap that you had there was very interesting.
Yeah.
I like it. Well, I feel like if you are so hype on having a traditional basic ass wedding, your marriage is going to be the same and you're not like truly happy. And all you care about is like having the white dress in the wedding. Let me tell you something. I'm just going to say one shady thing and then I'll be nice.
She's clearing her throat. Oh.
Look at people's wedding pictures and I'm talking a hetero couple. Look at a hetero couple's wedding picture. And the woman, as we all know, she's perfect. Everything's been touched.
I don't know what weddings you're going to. She's not always perfect. Let's be honest.
Well, okay. She's pretty.
She's pretty close.
Just bear with me for a second. She's perfect for her.
Gotcha.
Right? I'm not saying there's no such thing as perfect across the board people wise, but perfect for yourself. You know,
gotcha.
She's everything is done. She's got the perfect dress, the perfect shoes. Her hair's been done. The jewelry. She has her makeup done. You know, she's done the makeup trial. She's done the hair trial. Everything. Then you look over at the husband. That motherfucker's pants aren't even tailored the right way. He's got 3 extra baggy ass inches on the bottom.
Oh,
he's got fucking stubble on his face. His hair's a mess. Like these women don't give a shit about their husbands.
Whose weddings are you going to?
I don't know. Look at anyone's wedding.
Because usually it's every time. It's usually the bride feels like I've met her telling their husbands to like do all that stuff. Like
they don't care.
To do all that stuff.
No, they don't care. Mm. Now, when they do care, those are the marriages that last, right?
Oh, yeah. I cared a lot.
Right. And but your marriage is successful.
Yeah, I didn't have to tell him to do it. Like, I just knew he would.
Well, you both are good looking people. Like, I'm just going to be honest. Like,
thank you.
You both are good looking people. And so you take care of your appearance and you care about your appearance.
Yeah.
And I respect that. I respect that in men and women. I think more men should care about the way that they look and care about their appearance and put more effort and straight men should put more energy and effort into it, because
especially on your wedding day. Come on.
Especially in your, I'm telling you, look at these schlubs. Like, it's one of these things that I'm the thing you'll notice the most. And I know that you probably, but look at the bottom of the pant leg. That's all. The pant leg is the one that goes on tailored the most.
It is,
you know?
It is important, because if not, you kind of end up looking like 90s from Friends, Chandler Bing. I don't know if you have a vision of what his suits used to look like, but that's what you fucking look like.
Yes.
Get it together.
That's exactly what it is. That's exactly what it is. And I know everyone out there is like, Sam hates weddings. Oh my God.
No, I think they're like,
you have the problem with men pant legs. That's really what your gripe is.
It's such a small act.
That's what you have nothing problem with weddings.
You understand what I'm saying. People, it's a very Seinfeld, like, you know, I hate this one specific thing. I don't hate the whole thing. And then I hate the basic tradition of it. I was telling Sam in the car, like, when I have a degree in sociology. So I took, you know, I studied all of that happy, happy stuff in college. And I took this class called marriage, which I effectively wrote at the top of my notebook every day and referred to it as mowage. Just to let everyone know. So if I slip into that, I apologize. But, you know, we learned so much about the tradition of marriage and where it comes from. You know, why do we have the rings? Why do we have the white dress? Why do we have the woman being walked down the aisle and given away by her father to her husband? It's all this, you know, patriarchal, misogynistic, old school, you know, reasonings that we do. Literally every single fucking aspect of the wedding is this traditional bullshit of giving this woman away as property and possession, the name changing, all of it. And so I just think that for me, I'm not a traditionalist. I think we need to shake things up. I think we need to do things in our own way, especially as feminists, especially as women. I think it's important to not just go with the trends that have been put before us, because those haven't really gotten us anywhere, you know. And I think that there's certain aspects of, oh, man, people are going to hate me for this episode. I think that there's certain aspects of marriage and weddings and everything that, like, I personally don't vibe with. Like, the idea that the man, again, in a hetero relationship, that the man proposes to the woman and does this big surprise, and, like, that is so immature to me. Like, the whole concept of that is basically saying the woman is ready for marriage at any given moment, and it's not her decision to decide when they, as a couple, together, as partners. Don't you fucking say that you call your person your partner if he proposed to you on one knee. That's your husband. Get over it. You know what I mean? Get over your shit right there. You are not partners. That is not equal. And so, like, I just, look, do your thing, propose on your one knee, whatever. But, like, don't act like it's original or like it's unique. You know, it's this concept that men are not ready for marriage, and that, you know, the woman is basically saying, I'm ready whenever you are, just waiting for you to be mature enough.
Well, what do you think about women who want that?
Who want what?
I was going to ask that too.
Because there's tons of women I know who would actually, I know, it's very tough. I agree.
Who definitely
like, a man proposes to me. Uh-huh. I do not propose to a man. Like, women,
it's
who
internalized misogyny.
It's tough.
And that's the problem.
Because I think that's ridiculous. It doesn't make any sense to me why it would matter. I hate all the nonsense of it. Mm-hmm. And then, but when I go, they're like, well, that's what I want. He should have to propose to me. No. I think there's that weird thing. I mean, tell me everything you know about it. It's a weird psychological thing where I don't understand where they flip it. And I go, like, why do you think that matters, though?
It's internalized misogyny. You know, we can internalize anything. All of this shit that's thrown on us, it's in movies. It's television. Sure. It's in books.
Yeah.
Everyone around you does it the same way.
Pull it from pop culture. Yeah.
You know, sure. And so, like, it's all that people know. And people are basic and they don't question anything.
So analyze me. So everything you go
I'm
through.
I'm sorry.
No, it's okay.
No, it's 100% your fault.
No, it's fine. I'm not offended at all.
I'm just kidding. I love you and Wes.
No, you guys are dope as
shit.
I just want to, like, compare like what you're saying with what actually happened for me. So So for me, in that sense, my mindset at that time was, you know, I'm the fucking prize. Come get me.
Yes.
You know, like, that was just my personal mentality.
Yep, you are,
and I'm not
prize.
Saying that's a female thing, or it couldn't be like a male thing too. I don't know, do you, whatever. But for me personally, I was like, you come get me.
Yeah.
Like he knew I was ready. Like I feel like you get in, you get when you're in a long term relationship, you get to a point where it's like this can happen anytime. And I just let him know like I was expecting it at some point. Type little nudges, you know,
of course. And that's how it always goes.
Yeah.
But that's my point. And look, there's nothing. Look, it's not your fault that you were ready for it.
Yeah.
And he didn't verbally say it that he wasn't ready for it. The reason that it's not your fault is because that's just how we were raised societally. Mm-hmm. That is what everyone around us does. And that is what everyone around us has told us is right. I'll tell you both. And I'll tell anyone who's still listening to this podcast at this point, because I know people get really touchy about the subject. And even very close friends of mine have gotten offended, you know, and felt hurt at my opinions on this sort of subject matter, family and friends, to be very frank, and have really like came at me for my opinions on this. And so which is why I feel like the need to defend where I come from, because I don't think it's easy to explain. I guess what was I getting at?
Well, you don't have to. I mean,
it's society, you know, it's society sort of saying that the woman is ready and the man isn't. And it's not Wes's fault that he wasn't the one saying, I'm ready for marriage, because we women are shoved down our throat day one.
Yeah, he actually was. He actually did kind of vocalize that, too.
That's cute.
We have a you know, I just want to put out there, you know, don't try and compare yourself to us, because we're fucking perfect. So, you know, it's just not.
Fuck yeah. That shit.
It just works.
You've been together for a decade. I mean, that is a legitimate relationship.
He got me at 22. Like, you know how hard it was to give up, like, all the freedom that I had at 22? Yeah. Because I was like, in the beginning, I felt like, you know, fuck, man. Like, there goes my sluttiness, you know, because I really like this guy. And he's so sweet. Like, he, you know, he would never, ever cheat. Like, he's just like, he's a catch. He's the diamond in the fucking rough. You know,
he's a gem.
Straight from Aladdin. He's the diamond in the rough. And, you know, I had to, he didn't have to change, but I had to change a lot. So I feel like when you, and I've said this before, and I know it sounds cheesy, but when you meet the right person, it just works. You don't have to try that hard. Like, people that are changing like all this shit about them, and they're like begrudging the other person, and they're like, fuck this, I have to do this because she's making me like that. Like, look at that situation. That's like, really look at how you're feeling about it. Like, I changed. But I changed for good. You know what I mean? I changed in ways that ultimately benefited me later in life. And I got more serious about things because I was a mess. But back to my original point.
You grew up together.
Like, when you meet the right person, it just works. You shouldn't have to be trying to make it work constantly.
And I agree with that. I think that lends to my point. So just for example, my mom's a super hippie feminist. I love her. And like, I grew up in a very feminist household. My dad is a stay-at-home dad. He raised me. My mom went back to work. She made more money. He hated his job. So when I was born, they were like, we're not paying for daycare. I was the third anyway. It doesn't matter. But I was the third kid. And at that point, just the way that it worked out, my dad was a stay-at-home dad for 5+ years. And then ran his business out of our home for the rest of our childhood. And so
that's so cool.
Yeah. As a wedding photographer, he was working on weekends and then editing photographs on his own time throughout the week. And so he was able to Monday through Friday be the dad and be the mom and cook us dinner and pack our lunches and do our laundry and do all of that shit. That's the household that I grew up in, you know, and that really shaped the way I thought everyone grew up like that. I thought everyone had a stay-at-home dad.
I didn't have a stay-at-home dad. My dad worked, but my dad also did all the cooking.
Yeah.
So my mom did not cook. And therefore, I never really learned how until I was much older.
Yeah.
Because I feel like I don't know. It was just something my dad always did. He was never like, hey, want to learn how to cook this?
Yeah.
But like the shit my dad makes, oh my God. Like, I've mentioned before, I'm from like where all the Amish people are, and the diets out there and the food that's regularly eaten out there is just not what people eat here. Like, a regular meal for us would be Spam casserole, which was actually fucking delicious, but it's made with Spam, which is some sort of meat that's found on a shelf, mind you.
Yeah, meat in a can.
And next to it, you will find Velveeta, which is a cheese, quote, cheese.
Yeah.
That's also on the shelf next to Spam. So two things that you would normally find like frozen or in a fridge are on the shelf. That's what we would eat. But yeah, my dad did the cooking. He didn't know what to cook, but he made some poor choices. But he did the cooking too.
And it's I think it's interesting to grow up with like a slightly different upbringing than most people, especially in that aspect. And like my parents, like they didn't, my dad didn't propose to my mom. They didn't do that. They decided to get married like adults.
Yeah.
Because like, I don't know, just like the way that my mom always described it to me, which is the way that I still feel now, is just like, I'm an adult. I didn't need your father to get on a knee and get a ring. She told him, don't get me an engagement ring. She did not want a diamond. She's like, don't waste money on that shit. I don't want a ring. She's like, let's just get married and do our thing. And like, you know, they decided as a couple to get married. And it always like it dawned on me when she explained that. And then I learned about what marriage was and I saw the way other people do it. And I just sort of thought, well, why shouldn't it be? You're making a huge decision. Like, yeah. A really big decision. Why should it only be one person's choice as to when that decision gets made? Yeah. And why should it be a surprise to the other person?
Yeah.
As to when it should be
like a mutual decision. Is that what you're saying?
It should be a mutual decision is what I'm saying. I'm not saying that we shouldn't get engaged or whatever. But I think what most people end up saying is, well, we both knew we were ready to get married. Right. But then they still go with this tradition of the, you know, man surprising the woman.
So there's a lot of divorce.
Yeah, I just think, look, if that's what you want and you truly believe that that's, you know, what you need to satisfy your relationship and your marriage.
Yeah,
that's fine. I just think that you should reflect on why we do those decisions. Or, for example,
why do you want that?
If you are in a hetero relationship and you both are ready for marriage, you've talked about it. Why can't the woman do the surprising?
I don't even know why they're surprised.
I don't know why they're surprised. Yeah, it's so immature, right?
Like a surprise. I mean, like, it's,
don't lie to me.
I don't know. This is your bag. You do whatever.
Tell us
so
your
much.
Thoughts.
No, I don't
want to
know.
How long have you been in your relationship?
Six years.
Wow. Like okay. Yeah. So is this a conversation you've had? It sounds like it feels like
trigger?
It is.
Are you triggered? Are you triggered?
I don't think I've ever been triggered, but maybe.
What'd you just call me?
But
yeah, I mean, you've been with your partner for 6 years and you live together, right? Sure. And now we're giving Neil's life away. Neil's like, I don't want to talk about this on the podcast.
No, see your thing. I didn't realize the marriage thing was like a thing. But yeah, the surprise thing I've always thought was, I mean, I guess, but also you could still keep, I guess there's all cool ways to do this and everyone feels an adult about it. Cause you could be like, we're going to get married. We definitely feel that. You have that conversation. And then eventually someone picks like, well, I'm going to do a surprise for you. You'll never know when. And then they run off into the distance.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And then whoever wants to do the surprise has the surprise event and, you know, does the like, boom.
Are you not into the surprise situation? Would you rather it just happen?
I'm going to bum. You think you're a bummer. I would piss off your friends. They would probably want to shoot me in the head.
Make me look better.
I'm anti-religion.
Well, I'm
so far over there. Be like, I can't even stand it when most of my friends, I was like, you've never stepped foot in a church and you know now you're having it in a church. I was like,
Are you judging me?
We just talked about this.
100% judging
you. No.
But like, it's not anyone's fault. Your parents are still alive. So your parents usually like guilt you into it. Yep. They're like, you have to do it.
Yeah.
I'm like, this is such
a that's where I think the difference comes in though, because I think there's a difference for people that want to do it and people that feel like they have to, because I feel like there's a lot of pre-existing traditions that have been passed down through generations and generations where it can be looked at as expectations. Sure. You know, like maybe the grandparents are like, you have to propose to my granddaughter. Like, you know what I mean? There's a lot of societal pressure and like traditional pressure that comes from that as well.
Yeah.
But I think there's also people like me where I didn't incorporate like any religiousness into my wedding. And so I had a venue, but I didn't like the way the venue was set up to have the ceremony there. I know it sounds weird, but it was like a perfect square. And in my mind, I was like, all right, I'm getting married. I never really wanted to get married before. I didn't really value the tradition. I just didn't see the point, you know, feminism.
Exactly.
But I met someone who changed my perspective, you know, as it can happen. And he made me want to marry him, you know, but I like was trying to find a place close by where I could have the ceremony. So there just happened to be a church there close by. Do you have any fucking idea how awkward it is to walk into a church that you don't go to?
Sure.
and ask for a non-religious ceremony.
So yeah. you didn't get married by a priest. You didn't have to do classes.
I did have to do classes.
See, this is what I mean.
We just talked about that.
Yeah, I had to do classes. So
did I miss it?
No. It was in the car.
We talked about it in the car. It was our lead.
Yeah.
I got you.
But that was part of the stipulation of us getting married there because, you know,
Wes and I are nice people.
So we were just like, hey, like, I know this is weird.
Yeah.
But like, we want to use your church and you possibly, if you're not busy on this day, like, can you marry us? We were just like, please.
That's like the dick tease of religion for a priest.
Yeah. Like, we were like,
sorry. I mean, that should never
please
be.
Please do it. Yeah.
That's so crazy.
Yeah. And I was lucky enough to have, it was like it all lined up perfectly because the preacher there was a woman. Woo.
Woo.
Already looking good.
Methodist or Lutheran or something?
I don't remember.
Okay.
But it was a church.
Beautiful day.
It had really nice stained glass windows. I don't know. But yeah, they made us go through like
somewhere. I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. It worked.
Baby Jesus.
They made us go through like this couple's counseling wherever where they like tried to get us to go deep and they like tried so hard to like get us to find like a flaw that we could work on or like something that like we can't stand about each other or whatever. And we were like, bro, you're wasting your time. Like, I don't know. We're good. Like, I don't know what to tell you. Like, they tried so hard to find something in us that they could fix like before we got married.
Right.
And we're just like, now we're good. But yeah, I ended up getting married there. I walked myself down the fucking aisle as if anyone that hasn't been to my wedding probably doesn't know that. But I walked myself down the aisle. Typically, you have your dad walk you down the aisle. Mine chose not to be a part of it. And he was actually supposed to marry us. And there was a whole thing and a falling out. And I ended up walking myself. And let me tell you, that is awkward.
That's weird.
And everyone that knows me knows I'm a person that doesn't mind being the center of attention, you know.
Yeah.
And in that moment, and all those eyes are on you, and everyone's just like taking you in, it's a lot.
Yeah.
And you know, the typical bride has someone there next to her to like take some of that energy towards.
Yeah.
And I didn't. And I thought like for sure I wasn't going to be emotional. I was like, I'm not going to fucking cry.
Oh, yeah.
Like, I'm just not like that.
Yeah.
I'll cry at like, I don't know, someone else's wedding.
Yeah.
But like, I just didn't think I was going to. And I did.
Yep. The real reason I hate weddings and marriage is because they actually make me cry like a baby. And I don't want anyone to know I'm a fucking sad.
Yeah.
And so that's the real reason. Just in case anyone wants to know the tea of it, it's because every time I'm at a wedding, I'm like, oh, this is so beautiful. I'm not going to cry. And then I bawl like
so
a baby.
So emotional.
And I don't even know why, because I don't even like.
Yeah.
It does. You know, it's
certain things
hit me that way.
Funerals. For me, funerals.
Really? I will never cry. I never cried at a funeral.
It could be detached. It could even be attached. Like, it's like an aunt of an uncle that I don't even know or something like that.
Yeah.
Or like that. I could, because you can see. But weddings, I laugh. It's bad.
Yeah.
I'm not good. It's not. Yeah.
You would have been great at my wedding.
I should be outside. This is all hilarious to me. It's not good. But
tell us more, Neil.
No. It's fine. It's all good. I'm sure I've talked about this on like.
He would have been at the table at my wedding.
He would have been at that awkward table.
I had this table at my wedding that I was telling Sam, and it was just like what we later called the party table.
Yeah.
So it was like the random people that Wes and I knew that didn't like really know anybody else there, or like any of our friends that came solo.
Right.
Like, couldn't even find a fucking date with losers. So we had to like throw them on
nailed it, dude. Caps in the middle.
Together. I'm just kidding. I love you all, everyone that came to my wedding.
That was for you just got me back for hating on weddings. She's like, oh yeah, let me make fun of your single ass. Haven't had a ring on that finger ever. Almost 30, huh?
I'm joking. I love you all. Obviously, if you came to my wedding, I paid $180 just for you to fucking eat.
Dude,
so of course
boom,
I love you.
Boom, just nailed
yeah.
it. I love
of course
it.
I love you.
Of
but
course,
this table,
yeah.
like they were the party table. And I was telling Sam that like we were talking about how we like dislike the traditional, like just boring ass basic wedding, like blah.
Yeah.
I told my DJ, I was like, no slow songs. I was like, absolutely no slow songs. We'll play one as the very last song and that's it.
Right.
And then we banned Taylor Swift. And we banned all synchronized dancing. I was like, I swear to fucking God. And I said this to the DJ, who just happened to be my friend. I was like, I'm not kidding. I was like, don't take this as a joke. If you try and play any of that to the right, I will lose my fucking shit.
Yeah.
Like that is banned.
Yeah.
And we just played like party pump and music all night. And there was so many drugs at my wedding. which I didn't find out until like the next day because I did not participate. That's not a lie. Anyone who knows me knows I'm not lying. Besides weed.
It's never good if the bride and groom do. I've been seeing a couple of weddings where the bride and groom are like fucking in the bag. And I'm like, no, gosh, you're not really supposed to be that drunk.
No, you want to be so. I know I it sounds that. Weird, but you want to be sober. A little sober. Nope.
I want to be the littest I've ever been. I want to like pass out and die at my wedding. Do you know what I'm saying?
The
like,
problem with that is the picture. The problem. Sorry.
Yeah. Go. Exactly.
You take pictures before.
Because everyone wants to.
You do.
Well, everyone also still wants to take pictures with you through the entire wedding. And if you're trying to get blotto.
That's true.
But you could put like a yo kibosh. Like, no.
See,
and
for
then
me,
I'd be down. That's a good point.
For me, you know, I just wanted to be present. That was my thing. I was like, I don't want to be fucked up. I was like, I want to be present. I want to remember this. I want to be here.
Yeah, I get that.
What does Cap want?
But then after party was different, so.
Yeah.
Cap just wants to, like, be drunk down the aisle, like, face down, like, by her arms, like, up to the altar. You would just, like, lift her head up by her hair, like I do.
Yeah, she does. Okay, back down into the bag, right?
You want to have, like, a liquid edible off to the side?
Yeah, vape. Yeah, I've always wanted to get, if I ever did have a wedding, I've always wanted to have like a cannabis wedding because you can incorporate, and now to talk about something I do know, you can incorporate, cannabis into your entire wedding. I mean, you can have an infused foods table. I'm talking about an illegal state, like, for example, Colorado. Sure. You can have it in a private backyard and you could have this all done legally. Now, PA is not that far from full legalization.
They really aren't.
We really aren't at this point. They're you know, our governor has been promoting it as
very vocally.
Yeah, one of the things that would help bring our economy back for
go Governor Wolf.
Hey, yeah. And honestly, I mean, he's 100% right. The medical program has already brought in so much
money.
He's
woke.
Yeah, he's pretty chill. I mean, they're not stupid when they see, you know, people always talk about, oh, medicinal, it's not legal. Why is it not fast enough? You know, you have to have medicinal to prove legalization. And the minute that the government can see how much money they can make for medicinal, they can make so much more for legalization. One of the reasons being, which people may or may not realize, at least in Pennsylvania, for medical marijuana, you're not able to tax medicine.
Right.
And so there's no taxation on it. Mm-hmm. So the government is making their money.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah. Right. Look at your receipts. You're just paying straight up.
I don't look at those. Who knows what the fuck
I pay. I look at Sam's life.
I like.
You're like, here you go, bitch. Make it rain.
Hardly.
I'm just kidding. I'm totally kidding. Totally kidding. And but so you can't tax it. So they make their money from when people apply for their certifications, which is $50 mm-hmm. per person. And then when they recertify another $50, that's where their money comes in. And then also from the dispensaries and the growers applying for their licenses is about $1 million in fees, literally $1 million in fees. And that money goes to the government. So that's where the government is making their money currently in Pennsylvania from the medical program. But moving forward, if they were to legalize it, I mean, they have huge taxes, you know, in Colorado. I think the tax is like 30% or 40%, and you end up paying just a wild
for like edibles and stuff
for all your legal gotcha. products. You pay this huge time. I'm fucking up the number. It's 30% or something, whatever it is. It's just like a massive, you know, we pay 8% here in the city, and then it's like whatever their city is plus their 20% for for the medical tax. And so
I have a question quick.
Yeah, but that's where they make their money.
Yeah, because I know you'll know this. So like for someone that has a medical marijuana card and they go into like a regular dispensary, they still get taxed?
Great question. So in Colorado, they still have that's a good question. In Colorado, they do still have medical dispensaries and legal dispensaries. So you can still be a patient. And actually, the benefit to being a patient is you get higher strength products for lower costs. And again, no taxation. The price is going to be lower. I don't know if it's just lower in general or if you're just getting the price without tax. I don't really remember. I was there a few years back. And then you also get higher strength. So like they would have, let's say, the same gummies from Wana Gummies or whatever, and they would have like, 50 milligrams in the medical version that you pay, you know, yeah. I think it's like 30%. That makes sense.
Oh my God. Even Alaska has recreational
medical.
Yeah.
Oh, is that medical?
Oh, recreational. I'm sorry. I just
Alaska's recreational.
So, this was on recreational. Just because I
didn't
was
know
wondering
that.
If there so was
Massachusetts is recreational. What the fuck, Massachusetts before us?
oh, so many states before us. They've had,
well, the,
they've
the had West Coast makes sense. Time. The West Coast makes sense.
Massachusetts has medical for a long time.
I did not know that.
The one, yeah, the one interesting thing that I, because, you know, they're near Vermont. Vermont's
been. Didn't I go on a road trip?
Yeah, Vermont's had medical for a minute, for a long, like 20 years or something like that. They were one of the first states with California.
Wait, who, Vermont?
Vermont.
Yeah. I didn't know that either. Mm-hmm. Let's go there too.
Vermont's are all the hippies retire, because if you go there, it's like all these old deadheads.
So you're saying just, we would both love it and really thrive there?
Yeah. I've never been, but I've, you know, I've
let's
heard,
go.
Yeah. I would love to.
Yeah.
I've never really been to that area, and I was planning a trip with Aaron. We were thinking about maybe going to like Massachusetts or something like that, but we ended up going to this Milwaukee comedy festival instead. So that's going to be our trip for the
that's
year.
That's cool too, though. I've never been there. I'm excited to hear your
I'm really excited
your for, thoughts about it.
Yeah, I'm really excited. I mean, it's I've never thought to go to the Midwest, and like we're going to be on our journey back and forth. We'll be hitting Cleveland, Ohio, Milwaukee, and then on the way back, Pittsburgh, which I went to college in, and then Philly, and obviously Philly.
You have
and
to check out all their vegan scenes.
I joined all the vegan Facebook groups.
Who's
I've
looking
been,
the best? What
Milwaukee
city?
Has okay. a great vegan
wow,
scene.
Okay.
They have tons of vegan food. But Cleveland actually has this adorable place called Cleveland Vegan. And it's like their vegan place, you know, and I'm excited. I got a hotel that's like right by there. And also like there's a comedy venue. They're both like within 2 miles of each other. So the comedy venue we're hitting, the Cleveland Vegan, and then our hotel's all right there. So, I mean, I'm excited that they at least have one. If it's just one place in Cleveland, I don't care. We'll go there for dinner and breakfast.
Yeah, you'll just try the whole menu.
Yeah, we're there for 24 hours. So I was like, I'll hit it twice. I don't
fuck
even
yeah.
care. You know?
You want to hit it twice.
Exactly. I mean, it's their only, like, you know, but I think the funny thing when you go to these, like, smaller cities or towns or whatever is that, like, the names of the places, it's like just Cleveland Vegan. You know, it's not
right.
like
it's their first one.
Yeah,
so.
Exactly.
And vegan the, first, vegan one.
Exactly. Whee! Yeah. Like, and then like the comedy place we're going, it's in this place. It's in part of Cleveland, I guess it's called Lakewood, or maybe it's a town off of there. I'm not really sure how it works, but and so like the comedy club is like Lakewood Tavern, you know, Lakewood Village Tavern. I'm like, oh, this is a cute little adorable place. But yeah, I mean, the one interesting thing, I was looking up like the weed laws everywhere, and Milwaukee's like strict, no. Wisconsin's like, no.
Like you'll go to jail, no?
Yeah, no okay. decriminalization, no nothing. We're not bringing, you know, anything with us or whatever. And Ohio has medical, which I didn't realize, which is funny to so many more states. And also in my searches, I realized that there's a lot of states that have what they call reciprocal medical programs. And so, like, if you're a medical marijuana card holder in Pennsylvania, we have reciprocity in like 20 other states where we could like legally go into their medical dispensaries. And I never knew that. And
great word.
What's that?
Great word.
Yeah.
Reciprocity. Like yeah. That.
Yeah. And it's really interesting. So like Ohio has a reciprocal program with us. We're only going to be there for a day, so it's not really worth it. But I mean, I guess the way that it would normally work is you would call them up ahead of time or let them know ahead of time you were coming and say, I'm a PA medical, you know, card holder. I'd like to come in. You like would have to, I think, sign up with them, maybe give them $50 or something like that. And then you'd be able to go into their dispensaries. But that's really fascinating. I mean, it's just so interesting.
That's dumb, though, because if you think about it, if you have a fucking driver's license from Pennsylvania and I drive into Ohio, that driver's license works in Ohio, too.
Right. Exactly. Of course. Exactly. And not all states. But the reason being is that not all states have the same like qualifying
true.
Diagnoses.
True.
So, for example, we have anxiety here in PA. They may not have anxiety.
Thank God.
Else. Thank God. So, you know, that's going to be one of the main reasons. But yeah, I mean, I'm excited. I think the next time we chat, I'll have been back from my trip. Am I fucking the
no,
dates
you're
up?
A no. little you're a little fast.
Oh, I'm just really excited. We'll have one more.
Stop recording. Rushing life.
I'm just ready. I'm ready to leave Philly and see other things. No, that's right.
I feel that.
You're right. One more recording and then I leave a few days after that.
Yeah.
So I'll be very stressed next time thinking about all of my.
Great. Good. It'll make for good content.
I'll be like sitting here just like, all right, what do I need? What do I need? Like,
yeah, it's either that or we talk about the G word again. So I think
yeah,
never
that'll get you
this
going.
Was the worst
that
episode.
The
I never
time.
Want to do that again. That was hard.
We're not even in October.
Talked about my least favorite.
I know.
Things.
My favorite month is soon here.
Sam, is there anything else you want to say before we wrap up?
No, I think we're good.
That was fun. That was,
yeah.
We covered the G word. We covered weddings, all my least favorite subjects. So
yeah.
Everyone be prepared.
And my
to
favorite.
Hate
so thanks
me.
for for meeting me halfway.
Yeah, everyone's going to cancel me and yell after this episode, especially.
But they're going to love me.
Yeah. Yes. They're going to be like, oh, we just want to look at her beautiful wedding pictures. I bet it was picturesque.
And oh, you guys can go to the Same We Are podcast on Instagram and Facebook. Yes. So I'm pulling that up. You guys can go to those cool places.
Yeah, we made some things.
Yeah, we have things. We also, which it'll be live soon, but the YouTube channel, it's also Same We Are, all of that.
By the time this comes out, it'll definitely be up.
It'll be, but you're right. The Facebook and our Instagram, you can follow us. We'll be posting some like behind the scenes and some teasers and little stuff like that. So,
Same We Are podcast.
Yeah, at Sam We Are Podcast. Everywhere. All the places.
All the places.
All the places. Well, this has been super fun. This is Sam Cap and Sam Dub with Sam We Are. Sam. How are you, miss? Sam. Sam We Are. Sam. Sam We Are. Sam. How are you?